Base year, I told you 11, 2011 and 12 is the base year. Yeah. Then there is a sub-index in world, in wholesale price index, there is a sub-index for food index. Or wholesale price index, food index is a sub-index in wholesale price index. That means, no, only they take the food grains into food related items into calculation, and then they calculate food index. But food index will not totally represent wholesale price index. Wholesale price index, there is the way of calculation. I tell you, 697 items comes into this category. That means the price of 697, the change in the price of 697 items is taken into consideration to decide wholesale price index. There are categories, primary articles. That means, you know, here are food related articles comes up. 102 primary articles are considered. The weightage given for calculating index is 20%. 20.12, but take as 20%. Then fuel and then power. In these 19 goods are placed in this category. The weightage given is 15%. Then remaining are all industry-related manufactured goods. Out of, say, 697. Manufactured goods weightage is given 65%. So food is 20%. Power and then fuel is given 15%. All other manufactured items is 65%. In this, what happens? If food prices increases drastically, the wholesale price index is not going to be changed that drastically because the weightage is only 20%. If production units are disturbed, that 65% weightage, production goods produced, if that sector is disturbed, even 5% cost variation is there in 65% weightage, then automatically there will be a change in the world wholesale price index. So taking all these things into consideration, Urjit Patel committee has recommended that wholesale price index should not be taken as a criteria for inflation. For all economic policy, monetary policy, which is to be implemented by RBI or government of India, wholesale price index should not be the criteria. Instead, you will have to take consumer price index as a standard measure, because consumer price index actually reflects the cost variation in the society. When you are purchasing some item, the increase in the cost of the item definitely reflects on your condition. But in the wholesale way, if it is happening, common man is not included. It is only for the business houses you are calculating a price index or raise. But consumer price index, it reflects any amount of price rise in the goods which are generally bought by the common man in the society. So Urjit Patel committee recommended CPI should be the criteria to be adopted by the government of India for formulating any monetary policy or monetary measure. That this will not be this recent happening. Urjit Patel was only an year ago when he was in the he was in the World Bank. Then he was a RBI governor. After Raghuram Rajan, Urjit Patel was given a chance. It is his suggestion. Then this WPI can be measured as week average also. It can, and point to point is nothing but this week you calculated, next week again you calculate a wholesale price index. What is the difference between last week and this week? That is the point to point. Otherwise, you will calculate all 52 weeks or the whole year, and then you take average of it, that becomes now wholesale price index. Both methods now you can calculate. Then I will tell you about a consumer price index and then now close the topic. Consumer price index is nothing but a comprehensive measure used for estimation of price changes in the basket of goods or services representing. Representing consumption expenditure in an economy. Am I clear? Is there some difference? Some disturbance is there? Am I clear? It is simply that is the wholesale in bulk. This is a retail purchased by the common man. That's now same thing I told you in sentence form. It's based on the weighted average. Again, similarly, like wholesale price index, consumer price index is also calculated as a weighted average about cost of the living. RBI uses CPI as key measure to that monetary or credit policy. Here, base year is taken 2012. Key, why this WPI is changed to CPI? Based on the recommendation of the Urjit Patel Committee, government is taking this as a key measure to formulate any policy. Four types of CPI are there. This consumer price index in respect of industrial workers, that is one measure. Industrial those areas, the difference in the prices will be taken, that CPI will be different. Then CPI is there for rural laborers. That is another. There, the criteria, the goods purchased by the laborers in the rural area, that is taken into criteria and CPI is fixed there. Then CPI, non-agricultural laborer in urban areas. That means employable people. Employees, what is the category? What are the kind of items they are purchasing? What is the difference in price rise? Then rural then CPI in urban, rural combined. This is another method. So four types of consumer price index is calculated for four categories, and CPI is decided in respect of each category, that is decided like that. Subsequently, the statistics department of Ministry of Commerce and Industry, they came up with another set of measures, CPI measures. Instead of calling this CPI rural, CPI urban, CPI combined. Three measures can be adopted. Here, what is the difference between CPI is rural and then now CPI industrial laborers? CPI industrial laborers speaks about the industrial laborers consumer price index only. Agricultural laborer, you are talking about agricultural labor only. But in a society, in a rural segment, there can be laborers, they can be workers, they can be farmers, they can be other categories. So they need to take the condition of all people involved in that particular society, rural, and then CPI has to be fixed. So along with that four CPI indices, these three CPI indices are also taken into consideration. Here, food grains is given. Almost 46% weightage is given for food grains alone in all these indices. So with this, I'm stopping at consumer price index. So I dealt with wholesale price index and consumer price index. In my next lecture, I will be covering the differences between wholesale price index, consumer price index, and the remaining terms related to that. I will also deal with gross domestic product, national domestic product, and per capita income. These terms also I will make you familiarize with.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Any doubts, children?